Hello, my name is Dr. Raj Iyengar. Stroke is the leading cause of disability and can be fatal if not recognized early. Until recently, the only approved treatment for acute stroke was IV tPA. Now we have a new option. It's called intra-arterial mechanical thrombectomy, which essentially means removing the clot from the blood vessel that caused the stroke. This is available in selected centers in Las Vegas area, including here at Sunrise Hospital, the only comprehensive stroke center in Las Vegas. Despite new therapies, the fact remains that time is brain. Having a measurement scale that first responders can use while in the field to detect potential large vessel occlusions or LVO is essential. This is the first and extremely proactive step in confirming the diagnosis and offering the appropriate treatment. One such scale to identify large vessel occlusions in the field and adopted by Clark County EMS is called R.A.C.E. scale. R.A.C.E. stands for Rapid Arterial Occlusion Evaluation and is replacing the Cincinnati Stroke Scale that is currently in use by EMS in Clark County. The R.A.C.E. scale is a pre-hospital neurological assessment scale to detect acute stroke patients with a high probability of large vessel occlusion. It has been validated in many studies. Now, I'm going to go over how to perform the R.A.C.E. scale. The first component of R.A.C.E. scale is facial palsy. For this assessment, we are looking for facial asymmetry of the mouth when a patient smiles or shows her teeth. Let's try. Can you smile for us? Show me your teeth. Here she's able to do it perfectly well, and there is no asymmetry. That would be a score of 0 for this particular assessment. Let's try again. Can you smile for us, please, and show your teeth? Okay. Here she has a weakness on one side, which here it would be the right side. She's able to do it, and it is a milder version of the facial asymmetry. So you would score it as a 1. Can you smile, please? So here you see that it is even more severe in terms of the facial asymmetry. This would score as a 2 in this particular assessment. The next component after facial palsy is arm motor function. In this assessment, you're looking for weakness or drift of the arm. Can you lift your arms up, please, with your palms up in the air? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this would be a score of 0 because she's able to do it perfectly well. Let's try again. Can you lift your arms up, please? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here she has a drift that essentially ended up being not able to hold it up for 10 seconds. So that would be a score of 1. Let's try again. Can you hold your arms up, please, again? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Thank you. So here she's not able to lift the right arm at all, and that would be a score of 2 for this assessment. The component after arm motor function is leg motor function. In this assessment, you are testing for leg weakness or drift. Here, we ask the patient to lift their leg up for 5 seconds, and each one is going to be tested individually, and we'll see what she does. Can you please lift your left leg up for 5 seconds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you lift your leg up, please? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So she has done it in both the legs, and so the score is going to be a 0 here. Let's try again. Can you lift the left leg up again? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you lift the right leg up again, please? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So she was not able to lift and hold it for the full 5 seconds and dropped it after a few seconds. That would be a score of 1 for the right leg. Let's try again. Can you lift the leg up, please? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you lift the right leg up again, please? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here she's unable to lift it off the bed, and that would be a score of 2 for this particular component. The next component after leg motor function is head and gaze deviation. In this assessment, you are looking for either the patient's eyes or head deviating to one side or favoring one side, ask the patient to move the eyes left to right and move her head side to side. If she can do both, head and gaze deviation is absent, and the score is zero. If the patient has evidence of trauma or a fall or requires spinal motion restriction or is wearing a collar, do not raise the head and neck. If the patient has her eyes or head turned to one side and the head and gaze deviation is present, you will score a one. So let's do the assessment on the patient. Let's look at the eyes. Follow the eyes to the left, follow the eyes to the right. So she's able to do both here, and the score is going to be zero for this particular component. Now let's try again. The eyes, and here she's not able to move the eyes across over to the right. So that would be a score of one. Now the next thing we're going to look at is the head movement. Can you move the head to the left? Can you move the head to the right? So she's doing both, the score will be a zero. Can you move your head to the left? Can you move the head to the right? So here she's not able to move the head to the right, that would be a score of one for this particular assessment. The next component in the R.A.C.E. scale is aphasia, which is a test of language function. Here you test the ability of the patient to follow commands. Now you only do this assessment if the patient has right-sided weakness. If your patient does not have right-sided weakness, you don't perform this assessment. So we're gonna ask two questions to the patient, and let's start. Close your eyes and make a fist. So here she does both the components. She's able to close her eyes and also form a fist. That would be a score of zero. Let's try again. Close your eyes and make a fist. So here she's able to do one, but not both. And that would essentially score her as one for this particular assessment. Let's try again. Close your eyes and make a fist. So here she appears to not understand the command and is not able to perform either closing the eyes or forming a fist. And that would be a score of two for this particular component of the test. It is also important to note when asking the patient to make a fist that she's using the unaffected side, which would be the left side. Because remember, you only do this test if the right side is paralyzed. The next component in the R.A.C.E. scale is agnosia. You do this assessment if your patient has left-sided weakness. If the patient does not have left-sided weakness, you do not perform this particular assessment. With this assessment, you are looking to see if the patient can recognize what is going on. Ask whose arm is this when you show her the affected arm. In this case, the left arm. And if she says mine, then it is correct. If she says I don't know, or another inappropriate response, then she is not aware. Then you can ask her, can you move your arm? If she says yes and can move her arm, that is correct. If she's paralyzed and still responding, yes, I can move my arm, that would be an incorrect response and she's unaware of what is really going on. If the patient can recognize her arm and attempt to move the arm, your score is zero. If she does not recognize the arm or is unaware of the arm, you score one. And if she does not recognize the arm and is unaware of the hand, then you score a two. So this would be the weak arm or the paralyzed arm on the left, and you use that arm and show it to her and see, whose arm is this?
This is my arm.
So she's able to recognize the arm. Can you move your arm?
No, it's weak.
So she's able to recognize that she is weak and she has given an appropriate response. So the score would be zero. Let's try again. Whose arm is this?
That's mine.
Okay. Can you move your arm?
Sure.
All right. Here you see that she has given one appropriate answer and one inappropriate answer. She is able to recognize the arm, but she's not able to move the arm. And that would be a score of one for this particular assessment. Let's try again. Whose arm is this?
Yours.
Can you move the arm?
Sure.
So she's doing neither. That would score a 2. This concludes the race scale assessment. After the assessment, you add up all the components, and if the patient scores 5 or higher, this is a high probability that your patient is experiencing a large vessel occlusion kind of stroke, and the patient then needs to go to a stroke center that has 24/7 on-call neurointerventional radiology coverage for a possible mechanical thrombectomy. Thanks for watching.